Hey there, thank you for tuning into DuckBricks, and welcome to another breaking news LEGO video. This topic is on LEGO City. Now, City is personally not a theme that I collect 100% of, unlike many of the other LEGO themes. I typically will only probably buy sets that personally interest me. Some of these interests include new animal molds. And oh boy, is LEGO City having a strong showing in terms of brand new animal molds this season. So for summer 2021, LEGO City is doing a full-on safari theme. So that means we're getting lions, we're getting elephants, new colors of crocodiles, and even new prints for snakes, monkeys, and all sorts of really awesome new animal molds. So without further ado, let's just dive right in and take a look at these brand new LEGO City sets.
Alright, so we only have three sets to talk about that have been revealed so far for LEGO City, but these three are packed full of some fantastic animals. Let's take a look at the smallest set first, set number 60300. So this includes a small buggy, a drone, one minifigure, and two brand new monkeys, which obviously are the star of this set. Just a quick note about the buggy though, it does incorporate the brand new turning action feature that a lot of the city sets for this year have introduced. I actually have bought quite a few of the sets that have this feature, and I can confirm, it's quite fun to play with. But speaking of the monkeys themselves, this is a mold that I find is really nice. They finally have updated the classic LEGO monkey, which we last saw actually for Ninjago Skybound, where we actually got the Monkey Wretch minifigure in a silver form, but I think that this is a very much well-needed upgrade. Previously, they couldn't actually do a facial print on the monkeys, and they always felt a little bit uncanny using standard LEGO minifigure arms. I know a lot of people like the classic look, but personally, I'm happy for an upgrade, and them being able to grasp onto accessories is definitely a big plus. They also look a lot more realistic compared to the older monkey, so I'm pretty happy all around. I also like that this set includes two of them, and I'm really hoping that these become available on LEGO Bricks and Pieces, which is the LEGO parts ordering service, because that can mean you can army build some monkeys. But honestly, beyond that, not too much to see with this set itself, so let's just move on to the next set, set number 60301, which actually is a 4 plus or junior set. Now this is a must buy for me, for a number of reasons. Let's hop back on over to my collection, so I can talk about why this set is so significant.
So all the way back around 2015 or 2016, we got a whole jungle exploration LEGO City line, and with that, we got a brand new mold set for different kinds of big cats. We got panthers, tigers, leopards, even in more recent years, a saber-toothed tiger, as well as a female lioness, all which share similar styled head molds and the same lower body. However, we never actually got a regular full-on male LEGO lion. Until today, and I am incredibly excited to see that debut not just a full-on male lion in this style, but also a lion cub as well. So with the lioness from the recent city sets, you can complete the lion family. Let's dive into that.
So taking a closer look at the lion animal mold, I think it's absolutely fantastic. I have been wanting a full-on LEGO lion ever since they started doing the large cats for the Jungle Exploration series of City, and they finally delivered this year. I love the way that the head works and it's dual molded, which means that you actually have the full mane, and I do appreciate the use of the older LEGO big cat mold for the base of the body, which makes it keeping in style with the other animals. The lion cub is a very cute animal, and definitely one that I want to get multiples of, again hopefully on Bricks and Pieces, but the surprise standout to me, which I did not expect at all, is the rattlesnake or some sort of a jungle snake here. I was not aware that LEGO could actually print alongside this entire snake piece. You see, this snake was introduced for the Harry Potter collectible minifigure series all the way back in 2018 when it first debuted, featuring Nagini, which was Voldemort's snake. We saw it again a few times, but always unprinted in some of the larger Hogwarts sets, which is why I was shocked and very happy to actually see this snake in a full-on print. And again, I hope we can get multiples of this, because I absolutely will. Of course, the rest of the set is honestly nothing too much to see, you just got some sort of a water-river build, as well as a very juniorized truck. One thing I will note is that I do really like the tan color scheme, feels very much like a safari vehicle. But it's a 4 plus set, so honestly, I can't complain too much. It's one of the better 4 plus sets in a while because it includes 3 brand new animals, 2 of which are new molds, and 1 of which is a brand new color. So I can't complain. I love this set. I will be getting it immediately on day one. And then finally, we can move on to the big one, the final set, set number 60302. So this set delivers on the animal front in so many ways. First of all, we have the star of the show, a brand new elephant and baby elephant. Let's jump over to my collection to talk about how significant this is.
So this particular mold is very, very exciting to me. The last time we got a regular LEGO elephant was all the way back in 2003 for LEGO Orient Expedition. We got one in light gray and one in dark gray, and they were basically in the same style as the dinosaurs of that time. They were pretty simplified, but still nice to get, and the head mold is always a classic great one. Unfortunately, we wouldn't actually see any more molded elephants until LEGO City introduced the Woolly Mammoth mold for the Arctic line in some of the more recent series. This was a fantastic mold to get, and immediately the moment I saw this, I was wondering, will LEGO actually use the template for this to make a full-on elephant mold for LEGO City? And sure, we've gotten elephant molds for friends and whatnot, but honestly, it's not quite the same to me because personally, these aren't too realistic in terms of a regular LEGO minifigure, and definitely would look kind of out of place in a regular diorama. That's what makes me so happy that we're actually getting a full-on, realistic elephant mold in this year's summer sets. Let's take a closer look at it right now.
So taking a closer look at that elephant, it reuses the same sort of style as the Woolly Mammoth, but all of the parts are completely brand new, which is really interesting to see. I would have honestly expected for them to reuse the body of the Woolly Mammoth, but they chose not to because it actually had some molded in fur, so it's just along the same style. Of course, the head is very similar if not the same, and the trunk is the same piece, but it looks fantastic as a LEGO elephant, and the baby elephant also looks really great. I'm really happy they didn't just reuse the Friends animal mold because I felt like that one was too juniorized or maybe just the style didn't quite fit City. They actually put in the effort to do a brand new mold for the baby elephant, which is amazing to see. But those are not the only new animals in the set. Let's compare it against my collection to take a look.
So back for the Swamp Police theme of LEGO City, we got an updated version of the LEGO Crocodile in dark green. Hit Inside just a couple of years ago finally recolored it in light tan right here, but now finally we are just getting a regular plain green style standard Mata green or whatever you want to call it, regular green crocodile, which we never actually got before. So it's quite interesting to see, and let's take a look.
So zooming in here on this brand new crocodile, it is, again, the same crocodile mold we've gotten for the past few years, but in this standard Mata green color, which is fantastic. I absolutely love that we're getting the crocodile in a new color like this. That's also very, very realistic. What's also very nice that maybe is not immediately obvious from the box art is that we're getting a special print on one of the standard egg pieces to show an eye peeking out. Now, when this part first leaked, I thought it was actually going to be part of the Jurassic World series and act as a dinosaur egg, and I actually don't see any reason why it couldn't be, but it also works just fine as a crocodile egg, and I hope that they put that part in more sets. We also get two brand new monkeys, which are nice to see as well, nice that they included them in this set, so all in all, it's a very, very good showing for different animals roaming around the terrain. And speaking of the terrain, I actually am kind of a fan of how they built this. They used the brand new LEGO City road plate pieces, but recolored in blue for the water, as well as tan for the ground, and that immediately makes me start thinking of all sorts of new layouts that you could do by combining these road plate pieces with existing plates, just like they've done over here. I like the use of the differently colored terrain featuring the elephant footprints on the grassy side, and really getting that light azure or creamy colored blue color for the road plates is nice to see. Moving on though from this terrain build, I think the rest of the buildings are alright, nothing too special. It's of course a smaller 6 plus set, so I'm not expecting too much from the builds. One thing I do love, as I mentioned before, is this color scheme. We haven't really seen this color scheme used in really any LEGO set I can think of, other than even maybe some of the Dino Attack stuff where they use the tan for military helicopters, but I think the tan really works for some sort of a safari expedition. The helicopter we've seen a thousand times before in LEGO City, so whatever, I mean, it's nice to get that in tan, but nothing that's too crazy to me. Something I do kinda like about the tracked vehicle is that it really harkens back to some of the classic LEGO Adventurers builds, especially some of the Dino Island stuff, so that's honestly something I think is pretty nice to see. It's a very classic style build, very simple as well. And then moving on to the actual build itself of one smaller tent. The biggest standout to me are the flap or flag pieces in tan, which will definitely be useful for mocks, but nothing else about it really stands out too much. Obviously, the star of the show are the animals, and I can imagine many people getting this set, myself included, just for the animals. Before we wrap up this video, actually as I was recording this, there was one more large direct-to-consumer set revealed for this LEGO City Wildlife subtheme, and it includes a lot of animals, including another new animal. Unfortunately, we just have this one relatively blurry image, but I'll do my best to describe it based off of this. The most important thing to note with the set is we are getting a brand new white lion minifigure. Seemingly the fur coat is a little bit lighter than the other lion, and this animal actually did leak a while back, so I was wondering where it was when I was looking at the images of the other sets and noticing it wasn't there. Well, it turns out it's in this set. But not only do we get this new lion in a new color than the other set, but we also get two new lion cubs, one of them is in the whiter color, as well as a lioness who first appeared in one of the other LEGO City sets, and even a variation of the elephant with longer tusks, so we can actually complete the elephant family, which was started in the previous set. In terms of other animals, this set also features the return of the LEGO Eagle mold, which we haven't actually seen since one of the Fun in the Mountains people packs from a few years ago. And what's super cool about this is that it appears that the face has been recolored to resemble a vulture, which makes it another brand new animal. That being said, I do kinda wish that they'll put the eagle in more sets because it was a pretty nice mold, and I personally just missed out on getting multiples back when it was available on Bricks and Pieces, so I'd love to see that make a return. The set also features what appears to be a recolor of the new dual molded monkey, this time in pure tan and dark gray as his face, which is really cool seeing that part already get a different style of color for this particular set, especially because it's just been introduced for this wave. For the builds in general, one thing I do actually really like is the fabric piece being used as the awning for that building in the back as the treehouse right there. The road plates being used as a river also looks very good, as I mentioned in the previous set, and I think I actually kind of like the build of this set a little bit better than the other one because we actually also get a small cave for the lions and a pedestal for him to stand on in a very iconic fashion. Of course, the humans' vehicles are nothing too interesting, literally just a standard truck, a little hang glider, and a motorcycle, but again, I do appreciate the color scheme, so they're certainly more interesting to me than at least some of the other builds. All in all, the last thing I will say about this is that while we do not have prices for these sets, I am probably predicting that they're gonna be very expensive. LEGO City sets are typically already very overpriced, and this set features so many animal molds, which is really great, but it probably means the price is going to be somewhere around $150, maybe $180, or even if they're really pushing it, $200. Now, honestly, this is all speculation at this point, and for all I know, this is an $120 set, and it'll be really great and really well priced. But just looking at it, LEGO City is probably going to price this at really expensive, which they'll probably also do for some of the other sets. And finally, before we wrap up here, just one last thing I want to mention. I originally wasn't going to make a video on these because they're pretty juniorized and simple, but LEGO also revealed some Mickey Mouse sets, and we're getting a brand new LEGO Sheep mold for the Mickey Mouse sets, kind of along the same size as the fabled LEGO Goat, which is now very expensive on Bricklink. Now I'm sure that if this sheep doesn't appear in any other sets, the price on Bricklink is probably also going to be really high, and I'm really hoping we can get this one off of Bricks and Pieces because it is a fantastic new mold. This LEGO Disney set also has a ton of animals, featuring a return of the LEGO Ideas Blacksmith horse, which I've ordered a ton of off of Bricks and Pieces already, a bunny, and a chicken. So there you go for new animal molds of the summer. Not quite within the city theme, but close enough because we've been discussing animal molds mostly for this video anyway.
Alright, and with that, we've about summed up all of the brand new LEGO City Jungle Safari Exploration sets. Now, I do want to make a big note, these are not the only Summer 2021 LEGO City sets. In fact, they are releasing a whole wave of pullback motorcycles, which I also am pretty excited to get my hands on just to see the mechanics of that. Unfortunately, we still do not have official images of that particular wave of city sets, and personally, I wouldn't be surprised if this year's wave of city was split into maybe two different release groups because there's just so much to see. We've got all the jungle exploration stuff, but we've also got all of this whole stunt and motorcycle stuff, which seems to have an entire sub-theme all to itself, So maybe one of them's releasing in June, one's releasing in August. We still don't know at this date. I will be reporting on them as soon as we get images out, but for now, I hope you enjoyed this look at some of the summer 2021 LEGO City animal sets. Let me know down in the comments below, which animal is your favorite? Were you excited to get any of these animals, or are you still waiting on certain animals to be made in the LEGO City style? Personally, I'm holding out hope for a giraffe, and this is a big step in the right direction. But that wraps up this video. I'll talk to you again very soon. Thank you so much for tuning into Duck Bricks. Bye bye for now.